Last year, the hashtag OscarsSoWhite took the internet by storm. Looking at this year's successes with movies like Hidden Figures, Fences, and Moonlight, it seems like moviegoers are ready for more stories about people of color, and it's about time Hollywood caught up. Winston Churchill reportedly said, "History is written by the victors." And who are the victors of human recorded history? People of European descent. Think about it. In school, did you learn about any other culture unless Americans or Europeans were directly involved? Look at the Best Picture winners from the last 7 years. Spotlight, Birdman, 12 Years a Slave, Argo, The Artist, The King's Speech, and The Hurt Locker. Somebody's probably already in the comments like, "Hey, you liberal cuck flick, 12 Years a Slave's about black people. Get your facts straight." Yo, with all due respect, slavery is actually white history. Without white people with superiority complexes and being too lazy to do their own gardening, Africans would probably still be in Africa eating chebujan and fufu and having dope-ass African black parties. But like, for real, are you trying to make a slavery cinematic universe? Like Django's gonna show up at the end of Roots and be like, "Kunta Kente, I want to pick you for the Avengers initiative." Actually, that would be fire, I would watch that. There has been some restructuring in the Academy, so we'll see how this plays out. But if directors want to reach a wider audience, there are a plethora of stories that we can reach into without talking about slavery. Don't want to do the research, Hollywood? Well, here are my pitches for movies that people should see. Shirley Chisholm was the first black woman in the United States Congress, and the first black candidate to run for a major party nomination for President of the United States. After watching Hillary run for president, and while Hidden Figures is popping at the box office, this is a story that Americans have got to hear. Claudette Colvin was Rosa Parks 9 months before Rosa Parks was Rosa Parks. Not only that, but Colvin was arrested, tossed in jail, and then became an instrumental part in overturning bus segregation in Alabama, all at the age of 15. When I was 15, I was on the internet arguing that the Black Eyed Peas were the Beatles of our generation. I sucked. Or tell the story of the Brown Berets, a group of Chicano youth who looked after their community, just like another group we know, the Black Panthers. Or how about Malala Yousafzai, aka the youngest ever Nobel laureate? Yeah, there's a doc about her, but nowadays aren't we all about recreating things we've already seen? Fun fact, there was black history before slavery. Oh, and not Egypt, which you continue to whitewash, but Nzinga, the Queen of Angola, or Sunjata Keita, the Lion King of Mali. What did they do? I'm not gonna do all your work for you, Hollywood. That would be like, slavery. These stories exist, and they deserve to be told. Now, don't get me wrong, I love vanilla. Some of my best friends are vanilla. But I'm looking for my movies to be a little bit more Neapolitan. Oh, and if it's a movie about space fighting or a fantasy land, it's made up, so black and brown people can be in it. Look how diverse Rogue One was. We had Riz, we had Diego, we had Forrest, we had this guy, we had Jimmy Smits, and Donnie Yen? Tell me black people can't be in space. Space is black.